So you spend a few days scripting, recording and editing a video, and when you finally upload it, it only gets 20 views. Now this happens over and over again, regardless of how many hours you spend creating the video and probably the best thumbnail that could be. The worst thing is that this is happening to so many creators as we speak, but no one seems to have an explanation for all of this, not even YouTube themselves. Now I'm not talking about some bad videos with terrible CTR, because yes, we all might have bad days, but I'm talking about not getting views or impressions for that matter on some of the best videos in terms of quality. And it doesn't matter if you spend 5 hours on your thumbnail, it doesn't matter if your click-through rate is at 15%, it will still get 0 impressions per hour. And when I say 0, I'm not exaggerating at all. If you find yourself in this unfortunate situation, you should sit back and relax. Or no, you shouldn't sit back and relax, otherwise your whole channel will go flatline. Instead, you need to watch carefully what I will share today in this video and take actionable steps that will get you out of this unfortunate situation. By the end of this video, you will know exactly whether or not you are really shadow banned, and if you are, you will know exactly what to fix, because for every cause, there is a solution. In fact, this guy in here went from being shadow banned to getting thousands of impressions and views by implementing the tweaks I will be sharing in this video. If you want these results, then you need to watch till the end of this video, since the last tip will help most creators go from struggling to get views and being shadow banned like this to getting thousands of impressions and views like this. And for the ones saying that shadow banning on YouTube does not exist, then keep watching and you will be surprised, the same way I was when I made the discovery. Now, the life of a YouTube video starts in the moment you press publish. Unless you have thousands of subscribers, you highly depend on YouTube recommending your content, mostly through the browse feature. For those of you that don't know this, every video that is recommended to the YouTube's homepage falls under this category. The more YouTube recommends your videos out to a targeted audience, the higher are your chances of getting views. Now, I've been on YouTube for years, and let me show you what you need in order to get impressions. The click-through rate on its first 2 or 3 days needs to be at least above 6%, so you get thousands of impressions per day. Together with that, you need to have an average view duration of above 30% and overall a positive feedback from the viewers. Now, you can reach a high click-through rate with better thumbnails and a higher average view duration with better editing and better videos in general. But what if your average view duration is above 30%, your CTR is sitting at a whopping 14%, and you have an overall positive feedback, and you still get literally 0 impressions per hour? Well, in this case, we are certainly doing something wrong, and in order to fix it, we first must understand how YouTube works. Now, YouTube has only 2,800 employees, and there are around 3.7 million new videos uploaded on YouTube every single day. And just in case you still think that there is some YouTube employee watching your videos and not giving you views, then you need to think of it again. But just because some YouTube employee does not hate your videos does not mean that the YouTube algorithm loves them. YouTube has always been about being real, unique, and above all, human. With the rise of AI and the recent launch of Sora from OpenAI, you might notice that your videos might get less traffic and suggestions than before. To avoid that, you need to show to the YouTube algorithm that you are a real person. Now, let me show you what is happening right now to my channel. A few days ago, I changed the settings of my YouTube studio from this to this. And straight after that, I noticed that the YouTube algorithm almost completely stopped recommending the new videos with this new background. Nowadays, everybody can create a YouTube studio like this one with presumably an AI in front of the camera, and YouTube does not have enough employees to determine if a video is real or AI generated. Even if they would, that seems like an extremely boring job that nobody would be willing to take. So I believe that they are training the algorithm to favor the human created videos. However, since it might be at the early stages of it, it might happen that your videos get wrongfully categorized as AI generated. If you think that such footage can be easily noticeable, then take a look at this newly released footage of AI-generated videos from simple text prompts. Now, this whole thing is not yet available to the public, but I strongly believe that based on the high number of creators complaining about a significant drop in views these days, YouTube is already training an algorithm to face Sora from OpenAI. Now stay with me because there is something you can do about this as well. Well, as for now, I'm noticing something quite strange with my own channel. If you take a look at my analytics, you will see that my best performing videos through which I reach my audience are these two, where I pretty much explain the possible causes and solutions to shadow banning. Because of that, it happens that when I upload a new video about dropshipping, it gets almost no views or impressions because YouTube thinks that my audience is not interested on dropshipping. And in this case, YouTube might be right. From the people commenting on my videos, I have seen other creators making the same mistake of posting videos that are not within the same niche. Now, you might be wondering, Cleo, why do you keep making the same mistake again? Well, when it comes to creativity, I might be willing to sacrifice a couple of views and share with my audience what I love to do, even though dropshipping and YouTube growth are two different things. But the reason I'm sharing this mistake with you is because I don't want you to think that you are shadow banned just because you posted a video from another niche and you didn't get views. But what about the cases when your video is as human as it might be, it is 100% within the niche and you still don't get views or impressions? Well, in this case, I would be more than happy to introduce you to the concept of the mother audience. Now, YouTube has been around for years and differently from TikTok, they don't give you the chance to go viral that easily. Now, let me show you an interesting clip of two random people explaining what happens when you upload a new video on YouTube.
So you have these seed audiences. The seed audience will try and be like, it's not really that much interest, and then you'll see it drop suddenly.
Now, the guys that you just saw are not random people, but they are actually YouTube employees. Now, when you publish a new video, YouTube shows it first to a chosen audience, and the YouTube algorithm will very carefully evaluate all the feedback that comes from this mother audience. That is done because it wants to determine if it will recommend this video to a larger group of people or the graph will go totally flat like this. If your click-through rate is above 6% and your average view duration above 40%, there is a good chance that that video will keep getting views for a long time. Anything below that, unfortunately, will most likely stop getting views after the fifth day. Now, you might be thinking, hey, that is unfair because YouTube might show the video to some people that hate me and leave negative feedback on purpose and I cannot change that. Well, you actually can. There's a good reason a creator with almost 5 million subscribers still asks you to like the video in its first 1 or 2 minutes. Or others begging you to subscribe to their channel and turn on the notification bell. All of this is done with the sole purpose of building a loyal audience that will click on the videos as soon as it appears on the homepage. So don't be afraid to ask your audience to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. I know that you have heard this several times, but the first 24 hours of a video are super important. So far, I have shown you how to avoid being shadow banned, and now we have come to the most important part of this video, which is how to revert the shadow ban and make sure your channel goes back to getting views. Throughout these days, I've seen a lot of videos, and there are even people saying that their views went back to normal after they contacted YouTube support, like someone was turning on and off a switch. But I don't believe something as such exists. You can certainly try to contact YouTube and let them know of your issue, but in almost 100% of the cases, they will deny that shadow banning exists and they will tell you that everything is working as normal. So this is what you should do instead. First of all, make sure all of your videos are as human as they might get, with all your creativity and uniqueness. Second, make sure to stay within the niche and always bear in mind what is the audience in front of you. And third, make sure to create a loyal audience that will support your videos in the first 24 hours no matter what, so your video gets recommended to an even bigger audience. And fourth, and most importantly, you must understand that YouTube is a long-term game. And just because you are not getting views at the moment does not mean that you must quit or your videos are bad. Let's take a look at my channel, for example. 1 year ago, I was making 10 cents per day, and now I'm making $1 on average. There is a good chance I will make $10 by 2025, and the possibility I will make $100 a day by 2026. That will happen only if I keep on creating and trying to make my videos better, and the same will be true for you. I only told you three of the most recent reasons of a possible shadow ban on YouTube, but the list is non-exclusive and there are other causes of a potential shadow ban, and for each cause, I share the solution in this video in here.